It is 16 degrees outside, and I'm hot for some reason. It should be cold in here. Anyways, yeah, I got the fan on. I got it on 2 out of 5. It's got 5 settings. And I got it on 2. Anywho, this is a good fan. What is it? It's a Honeywell, and it's Quiet Set. Whatever that's supposed to mean is the thing it's got written on it. It's pretty good. It puts out a lot of air. It really does. When you turn up all the way, it really puts some air out. I mean, it really does. On 2 here, it's better than the one I have in the bedroom. But I don't want it blowing my hair, blowing me off the bed, basically, in the bedroom. I just want something to blow calmly on me while I'm trying to sleep. Anyway, speaking of the sleep, I slept through the night yet again, and yet again I feel not rested at all. I don't know what's going on. I haven't slept through the night in decades, literally since I was 10. I haven't slept all the way through the night, so... yeah, even when I was really drunk, I would wake up... in the night and whatnot. But I'm not rested. I feel worse than when I was waking up a lot. I don't know what's going on with this, but yeah. Anywho, I don't know what I want to do today. I don't want to play with the computer. I haven't turned it on. I did my tags with my tablet and instead of on the computer screen today. So I did 2 tags today, if you're interested. I did a bonus, you know. I did the regular 5-question 1 for the day, since I'm doing 3 months of them, and this is the second month. I got one more month to go after this, so yeah. It was a challenge for blogs, and where you spent 3 months answering prompts and in your blog. And I turned it into tag videos because it's fun to do tag videos. That being said, I have prompts for next month for videos, for vlogs, and I have blogging prompts as well that I want to do every day, unless the computer explodes or something like that. I want to blog every day with the prompts that I have for the blog. I have one for the for vlogging and one set for blogging. So yeah, it's gonna be fun. Jesus, hiccups. Hiccups suck. They do. But I have them every day of my life. Every damn day of my life, I hiccup. Usually while I'm talking. Mm-hmm. It's amazing how many times I've hiccuped while I'm doing a video, and then I watch the video to see if YouTube ate it or not, because it has eaten a couple of videos in its time, wrecked them or chopped them off, the end off, or had no audio or something dumb like that. So I always watched all the way through to see if they're okay. But yeah, every now and then I'll hiccup and not even know I've done it. I'll do it in the video, and I'll see myself doing it, and I'm like, I don't remember hiccuping at all, you know. I was bad. I had a sip of whiskey from a friend. He gave me a sip of whiskey, and I drank it. It was just an ounce of whiskey, so nothing to worry about. I didn't get drunk or anything like that. But it was my usual standard Alberta Premium. He likes that one too. And I have to say, it says 100% rye on the bottle, but I'm pretty sure there's corn in the mash. I'm absolutely certain of it. In fact, there's a little bit of corn sweetness in the just after you swallow, you get this corn sweetness and on the back end, and I'm pretty sure there's corn in it. And so, yeah, I don't think it's 100% rye. I don't think anything is 100% rye. I don't think I've ever had a rye whiskey that I thought was 100% rye. So. There's always been other stuff in it, you know, sometimes even a fruity taste, you know. There's almost no wind outside today. It's amazing, because we always have wind, and it's just about still outside. The wind is very low right at the moment anyways. So that's kind of remarkable, but yeah. I think I'm going to watch TV today. I'm going to watch TV shows today. I got into The Acolyte, a couple of episodes into The Acolyte, and I think I want to watch the other two that are up, because it's bloody good. It really is. It's really good. Speaking of really good, Doctor Who blew me away. I knew it was going to be a two-parter, so I missed last month. I don't know, last month, last week. And I watched them both last night. And I was like, holy crap, this is really good. I mean, if I don't play with my phone while it's doing it, while I'm watching it, it's good. It's really good. And I was glued to the TV. I really was. I was just glued to it. I was like, oh, the entire time. It was that same feeling as when I was a kid and I was watching the really old Doctor Who, the classic ones, and that absolute sense of wonder that I had that back, and it really was enjoyable. It really was such two really, really superior episodes. People thought that Disney was going to wreck Doctor Who. They did, I have to say, it's never been better since. A lot of people don't like the new Doctor, and I have no idea why, because this guy is a really good actor. Yeah, he acts a little not straight, we'll just say. I mean, he almost kissed a guy the one time there was almost a gay kiss, almost, but not quite, you know. That would have been good. I really wanted them to kiss, but they didn't. He's a very good actor. The first companion of the new Doctor is gone. She's been returned home. He's not traveling with her anymore by the looks of things. So there should be a new companion coming up. I was thinking they should have Captain Jack, but Captain Jack's not supposed to age. He's supposed to be able to live like a million years without aging, or millions of years without aging. If you're up on your Captain Jack part of the continuum of Doctor Who, you know that he eventually becomes the face of Bogue, and which is a giant head in a jar of liquid. So eventually he does die, because the face of Bogue dies. Y'all have a fabulous day, and keep smiling.